It's 2024. If it costs you your peace, it's too expensive. You can't afford to have things, people in your life that directly affect your mental health in a negative sense. Like, it's just not worth all of that, you know? This life of ours that we have, it's short. It's delicate. And it's very important for you to be in control of your happiness, okay? For you to be in control of your peace. And if there are things that are in your control that you are choosing to keep around, to be around, to work at, to work with, to live in, if it is causing you a decline in your mental health, then at what point is it actually worth keeping? If you're losing yourself, is it really worth keeping? I'm pretty sure it's not. And typically, I can't answer things for you, but it's not worth keeping. You know, things that destroy your energy.
I mean, we know scientifically proven everyone has an energy field. And what I learned when I went to classes at MIT for applied neuroscience, let's say we're in the room together, right? Let's say you're stressed out and your cortisol levels are spiking. That hormone is leaving out of your body, some of it, on your electromagnetic field and winding and interacting with my field, and your cortisol is coming into my body. So your anxiety, your anger, your frustration could literally directly affect me.
Things that destroy you on an internal level, they break you down consciously and subconsciously. Okay, if you are on a mental or spiritual decline, it will affect you physically. Okay, it can show up in your skin. It can show up in your body. It can show up in your elimination. Whatever it is, your body is going to start to become affected by these things that are costing you your peace. And so if you are spiritually affected, mentally affected, and then physically affected by things that are happening that you are allowing to happen, at what point do you hold yourself responsible to say, A, this is not working, and then B, I have to do something about it? Because it's not a sense of, oh, but if I let it go, it's going to hurt me. It's hurting you now. It is hurting you now. The sooner you rip the band-aid, the sooner and closer you'll get to your healing. Because again, if it's hurting you now and you're not letting it go because you don't want to feel the hurt of mourning it, you're just prolonging the hurt. The sooner you let go, the sooner you break free, the faster you'll get to overcoming the adversity. And then you'll be able to see the lesson. Because at the end of the day, it is our responsibility, this thing called happiness. It is our responsibility, this thing called peace. And we get to benefit, especially Gen Z and millennials, we get to benefit from all of the help that is out there. We have therapy, okay? We have personal development channels. We have books and Amazon, and things can drop at our doorsteps in less than 24 hours. We have access to so much. So now there's even more on our plate when it comes to self-accountability. If you are not happy with something, you probably have a resource to be able to change or make a change so that you can then find an outlet that leads towards happiness. Because it's not one thing, okay? Not one thing brings you happiness. If you rely on that one thing, like let's say shopping, for example, what happens after you buy that thing that it is you've been wanting to buy? The happiness is gone. Once it's in your closet or your garage or whatever it is, Now you're thinking about the next thing to buy because it's just a little small glimpse of happiness. It's not fulfillment, okay? And so in order to reach like a universal fulfillment within your own grounding and within yourself, you have to have a collection of things. You have to include your mind, your body, and your spirit. You don't want to be rich in your bank account, but poor in your spirit. That is why I am charging you to take the necessary steps to remove whatever it is that is causing you your peace. You have to let go and let God. Okay? You have to end so you can start anew. Okay? Sometimes you have to leave people behind so that you can get to a destination and then share how you got there. It's not always a matter of cutting people off or pulling the cord. It's just a matter of taking off the jacket and the heavy weight that's holding you back and then moving forward from there. You can always turn around and go back and help others, okay? Help whatever it is that you are leaving. But what is most important is that you help yourself. We live in difficult times these days, okay? Things are becoming very interesting on a global scale, right? There are wars that are happening. So now we're seeing, you know, the every man for themselves, or the every country for themselves, or the every religion or entity is for themselves, protecting their beliefs and what they feel is right, no matter who they step on. So if that is happening globally, then there is an energy being passed around, okay? And the number one thing that you have to prioritize through all of this is yourself and your well-being. And your well-being is like, it's like a triangle. You got to protect your mind, your body, and your spirit. You got to put yourself first. Because at the end of the day, you were brought into this world to live your life, not anyone else's. You have way more control over your life than anyone else's, even if you have children. Because one day they're going to leave the nest, okay? You don't own anything but this, yourself and your temple. And so doesn't that mean that you have to prioritize self? Doesn't that mean that you need to do everything in your power to make sure that you are showing up as your best self? And that's not to say that life will not happen to you, but if things are causing you your peace, if the things that life is presenting to you is in your control and you're choosing things that are causing your peace, then you have to make better choices. You have got to make better choices. Your decision making has to be better, even if you hurt people in the process, because you're going to continue to hurt them by enabling your bad behavior or their bad behavior. Or maybe it's a business that we're talking about. Maybe it's your house. Maybe you've lived above your means. Whatever it is, if it continues, so will the hurt. So the sooner you start to rip the band-aid off, the sooner you get to the healing, to the freedom, to the relaxation. Now the nervous system can go through the motions so that it can begin to self-regulate. So that your anxiety can go down and down and down. And so that a deep breath really feels like a deep breath. What goes in here and in here and in here and out of there and in here and out of here, it matters. So it's good to listen to nature and natural sounds and putting yourself in environments that you don't have control over. I'm in a natural environment. I have no control over what happens here. but I have control over how I respond. I have control over my fears. Oh, I heard a noise. How do I let that affect me? Am I scared? Or do I welcome the fact that things are living and happening around me because I am in nature? And bugs and things are going to be interested in me like I'm interested in it. Now, obviously, if I see something big, back up. But the more you get out in nature, the more you realize you're not in danger. I'm going to say that again. The more you get out in nature, the more you realize you're not in danger. Till you actually are. But a lot of things aren't trying to hurt you. And a lot of hurt we inflict onto ourselves. And a lot of it has to do with fear of letting go, fear of growth, and of a lot of other things. But I just want to leave you with this. If it is causing you your peace, it's too expensive. Let it go, my friend. And if it's meant to be, maybe it'll come back to you. And if it's not, you'll grow from it. You will. You can do this. I love you. Peace.